have changed that chocolate to you. I say things have changed. Power has changed hands. Can I get an amen? Amen. So, this week, Audu Maikori handed the position of CEO of Chalk City Music over to MI, and the vice president position is now being occupied by Ice Prince. But Audu made it clear that he's not leaving the entertainment industry. He simply handed that position over so he could focus on his new position, which is the president of Chalk City Group. So Chalk City Music will still be making hits like they've been doing for the past 10 years, while Chalk City Group will now be doing a little more than music. And Audu's contribution to the Nigerian entertainment industry did not go unnoticed. Hashtag thank you Audu was trending on Twitter. He definitely deserves all the recognition he's getting. And the way I see it, the way I'm seeing it now with this Chalk City Group thing, an empire is being built right before our very eyes. You'll see I said it. Welcome to The Gist. I'm your host, Toyosi Phillips. The Gist. Hi guys, welcome to the show. It's going to be an interesting one, as always. Joining me much later is celebrity stylist Kanayo, better known by her Instagram name Catch Me If You Can. She's stylist to Angela Simmons, and we're going to be talking about the BET Awards red carpet looks. There were lots of hits and, of course, lots of misses. And, of course, we'll be talking about being Angela's stylist. How does that work? Because Angela is a red carpet slayer. Like, always hits. Very few misses come to mind. So, we're going to be talking about that. So, the BET Awards held last Sunday, and of course it was full of many fashion hits and misses. We'll be talking about that later. But I just want to say that I love Rihanna. She is so playful. I don't know what was going on here between her and Mayweather during the show, but he must have been talking a tad bit too much because that duct tape was over his mouth before he could say, I'm a millionaire man, I got this, I got that. You know how Mayweather used to talk. So cute. Mayweather, by the way, according to Forbes magazine, made $300 million last year and topped the list of the world's highest paid athletes. Congratulations to him. Back to the BET Awards. Some of the highlights were when Diddy fell. That was funny. And I'm laughing now because he's fine. But it was really funny when it happened. He just never expected it. And another highlight was when Nicki won her sixth consecutive Best Female Award and thanked her mom.
Mommy, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything you've done for me. I love you so much.
So cute. Smokey Robinson received the Lifetime Achievement Award, and Ciara, Jason Derulo, and Tinashe paid tribute to Janet Jackson, who was honored with the Ultimate Icon Music Dance Visual Award. A lot of people, including me, thought Janet was going to perform at the event, but she just gave an acceptance speech and thanked her mom and her dad. Never get too old to thank your mom and your dad. All in all, it seemed like a well put together event. Yeah, so. Oh, and Beyonce won 3 awards, but she didn't attend. She and Jay-Z haven't attended that award in a while now. Someone said they act like cousins who feel too big to attend family reunions. I'm sure they have their reasons. Talking about reunions, there'll be one less cast member in season 8 of The Real Housewives of Atlanta. See, my mouth was wide open when I saw the news this week. Nene Leakes is leaving the show. In all honesty, leaving the show at this time is such a boss move on Nene's part. And I've been saying this for a while that Nene is actually trying to rebrand herself, take herself away from all the drama of The Real Housewives. So, a few weeks ago, she announced that she's now a part of the Kim Kardashian video game. The game made what, $43 million in the first 3 months? Yeah, so she's going to be a part of that. And then she announced that she'll be a part of a new show on ABC with Betty White and Anderson. I wanted to say Anderson Cooper and Anthony Anderson, a show called Tell the Truth. Nene is a hustler, good for her. So now we just have to wait and see how Real Housewives of Atlanta will be without her and Claudia. Claudia got fired last week. There's a movie I can't wait to see this fall. It has our very own Chiwetel Ejiofor in it. Yes, it's called Secrets in Their Eyes. And it's time for a new segment called Big Screen or Stream Screen. This is where I tell you what movies I'll be seeing on the big screen and what movies I'll be streaming. Secrets in Their Eyes.
LAPD just found an unidentified female body in a garage dumpster.
What are we doing here, guys?
Body appears to have been bleached inside and out.
Ray, what is it?
It's Carol.
It's your daughter.
What?
good for them.
That guy, I can't have you question him.
You're letting him go, aren't you?
I'm sorry.
He's guilty. We can't just let him walk.
Definitely big screen. I want to be able to grab somebody's hand and jump in my seat while watching. Yes, it looks like it's going to be good. And then there's Paper Town with Cara Delevingne. Cara, by the way, is killing it. Modeling, singing, acting, she's very okay. She's been everything she wants to be. So, Paper Town.
The way I figure it, everyone gets a miracle. My miracle was I wound up living across the street from Margot Roth Spiegelman. She was inarguably the most gorgeous creature that God had ever created. Margot's life was a series of unbelievably epic adventures.
Are you gonna spend the rest of high school pining for this girl?
As senior year drew to a close, Margot and I were practically strangers. Until this one night.
What the? Margot?
I need to borrow your car.
I think I'm just gonna stay in bed for this one. I'll stream it. But I'm still looking forward to these two movies. And that's it for Big Screen or Stream Screen. Now is my congratulations time. You know, every week I have to congratulate people. Thank God for good news. So congratulations to the Maven family, Korede Bello, Ricardo Banks, and Deja, who are all announced as Glow Ambassadors this week. So cool. Come on, come out far now. Your girl is here. How far? And congratulations also to celebrity photographer Yomi Black, whose wife Liz John Black had a baby this week. And also to Ike Ogbonna and his wife, who had a baby a couple of weeks ago and got married recently. So cool, congratulations. And sadly, this week, after 10 years and a day together, Jennifer Garner and Ben Affleck called it quits. They said they're not doing it again. They have 3 children, and the announcement really came as no surprise because there's been a lot of obvious tension between them for a while now. Jennifer once complained about Ben's drinking and gambling habits, and she also said she had to put her own career on hold so that Ben could have more time working on his career. Now the story is, after Ben's success with Argo and every other thing that he's been involved with, things never quite went back to being the same. Success is a dangerous thing, very dangerous. Yeah, so we're going on a short break now, and when we get back, I'll be joined by Stylist to the Stars, Kanayo. Don't move a muscle, this is The Gist. Welcome back. So with me in the studio is celebrity stylist Kanayo Ebi. She has styled Angela Simmons over and over and over and over again. And you guys know Angela is a slayer. Like, she hardly ever makes misses. So this is the person behind most or many of Angela's good looks. Welcome to the studio,
Let's
Kanayo.
Let's say the good looks. The good looks.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Wait, one thing I want to know. How is it being a celebrity stylist?
I mean, I guess they'll say, like, they're people, too. So it's, like, it's cool. At the end of the day, people get to see their looks on a larger scale. So I guess that would be, like, the fun part of it. You know, it's fun.
Have you always wanted to be a stylist?
No.
Really?
No.
If you weren't a stylist, what would you be?
I would be a psychologist.
Really?
Yep. I'd be a clinical psychologist sitting there taking notes and listening to people's problems. I still do that in styling, and I still get to incorporate in styling, but that would be really what I'd be doing, and I'd still love it.
That's so different. Okay, let's talk about the BET Awards.
Yeah,
the last BET Awards. Sunday, I saw some looks that made me cringe.
Of course, and it's then... the BET Awards. If you don't, I mean, the BET Awards is there. Like, you get to see all sorts of shenanigans at the BET Awards.
All sorts. But one outfit or one dress I had mixed feelings about, I couldn't tell if I liked it or if I hated it, was Kelly Rowland's. What do you think about her dress?
I saw where she was going with it, and I thought the concept of the dress was nice, and I liked it because I'm like a feather person. So I liked it, but the reason why I feel like people, it didn't really sit well with people, or like kind of look like out of place, was just because, I think because it was the BET Awards, the carpet is not that glamorous. Yeah. So it's like, you have the Emmys and you have like the Grammys and those carpets.
Yeah,
like, you know,
people
when you
really
go there, people really dress up for those awards. Like, the BET Awards is cool and it's a little bit more relaxed, and so it's more of like an in between glam and cool.
Okay.
Glam and edge. So it's not like that, like, oh, you know, ball gown, like really red carpet, but it's, you know, like, if you want to do that, it's still kind of like add a bit of edge to it, because it's not really like a dress up glamorous carpet event. Yeah. So I felt like maybe that's why her dress seemed like it was out of place. But personally, I liked it because she kept everything else simple. Her hair was simple.
Yeah.
Maybe if she did like a color heel, it would have been better for me. Like maybe something like funner. Then maybe would have like picked it up and made the outfit more fun.
Yeah, okay.
She the outfit kind of looks serious. Like it just looks really serious. Yeah. Like, she just looked serious.
Okay, who are your top three looks of the night?
I definitely would have to say Tracee Ellis Ross.
Yes, she
I love her. I adore her. I just love her style in general. Most of the stuff she wears and styles herself in is like from her closet and she just kind of throws it together.
Yeah.
And I think that's why I like because it's like very authentic. But I really liked her style. Her red carpet style was amazing. The all white look, the fitted dress. And she, apparently she designed it with the help of like, I was like, oh. And then all her like presenters looks, like she just looked killer. Like I was like, oh, you're definitely channeling your mom right now. Like she definitely was channeling, like she made, I know if Diana was watching, she was like, yeah, that's my daughter. Like, there go daughter, yeah. I like Rihanna's look.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pick as one of my top three because, you know, her look was very like classic, chic. And then she added that little, like, edge to it where and kept it young.
Yeah.
Because it could have easily gone kind of old. But she just kept it chic. She kept it, like, you know, just the jacket, the blazer, and the skirt because she had nothing underneath. So, like, brought it, like, kept it young, kept it edgy. And I just, and the gold was, like, you know.
Really.
So, I liked her look. It was simple but very classic and chic. And then, you know, I'll go ahead and be biased and say Angela Simmons.
So I was going to talk about Angela's looks. It got mixed reviews, you know that, right? A lot of people thought, well, some people thought it was too short.
Right.
Too short for the red carpet. And other people thought, yeah, she's young and she's...
People thought it was too short?
It made a worst dress list.
Where?
E.
Really? He gave her a worst dress?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Hmm. But I liked the dress.
Funny enough, it wasn't that short. No, what? I'm not saying it because I put it on her.
Yeah.
But it really wasn't short. Like, you know when you know something is short and, you know,
short, tacky, you're walking is different from
and
short.
Every time you make a move, you have to pull it down.
Yeah.
So it wasn't that. Like, it was, like, average length and she's not that tall.
Tall.
But, so, I thought it was, like, a perfect, like, length for her. Okay. Trust me, because there are times that we've tried certain things on and I'm like, no, that can't work. Like, it's too short. And she's like, no, I can pull it off. And I'm like... And we have that back and forth. So, yeah, I thought it was cool. I thought it was, like, something for somebody that wasn't, you know, presenting or just, like, was just attending.
Yeah.
It just had this simplicity factor to it, but added, like, the bit of glam with the, like, rhinestones and sparkles, and that's what I liked about it. It was Pat Bowe.
Okay.
Official, so it was, like, Patricia Bonaldi.
Okay.
She makes the dress. She has, like, a cool aesthetic. It's very young, and then she has, like... She always has, like, either nude panels, and she definitely does her thing with the, like, beading.
Did you notice any trends this year? I know last year there was a lot of white. Like, almost everyone was in white.
Yeah. I think people just did what they felt this year, to be honest. I didn't see any consistent
trends
or consistent, like, something that you say, oh, this was the trending color. This was, I did notice that black was, like, the safe color this year. Like, a lot of people did tend to do the black thing.
So before you leave, what are the style tips for this summer?
For this summer?
Yeah. How do I look glam and fabulous and hot every day this summer?
Hey, it's just about being comfortable every day this summer because this heat in New York right now. Maxi's always still a good idea. And then you have, like, the t-shirt dresses or, like, making a... T-shirt dresses, button-down dresses, like, all those things are, like, the big things for the summer as well. Like, a lot of people are putting it, like, it was in a lot of trend watches. Because it's just an easy throw-on-and-go thing. And then also in the sense of layering, like, you can wear jeans with it sometimes if you decide not to. And then, you know, you still have, like, your ripped jeans concept and the, like, denim. White is big for
white
the summer.
Big.
Yeah, white is big for the summer. Yeah. And, like, the denims are definitely big for the summer. Yep. Denim dresses, ripped denims, you know, matching denims. Oh, see, there you go. You're on trend. So that's definitely big. And, you know, like I said, the whole bohemian theme is big for the summer as well. So you see a lot of, like, fringe dresses, fringe, like,
bags.
And then you still have, like, the, like, paisley prints and the paisley dresses. That's why I said like maxis is still in.
Thank you for being here, Kanayo.
Thank you for having me. I had fun.
Celebrity stylist Kanayo here, everyone. We'll be back after the break. The end of the show, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Kanayo, for being a part of the show. So I've decided on what the prize will be for the 25th episode celebration. It's going to be a big one, and details will be on all our social media pages. So please follow The Gist with Toyosi Phillips on Instagram and Facebook, and The Gist with TP on Twitter. Happy Independence Day to all my American and American living viewers. Be safe in the streets, please. All this fireworks business, please be safe. I'll see you guys next week, and remember, you can be everything you want to be.